I can be the cheap warm-up act, right? So I will, I'll tell you just a little thought about Kathy Rasso here. Okay, stand up for a second, Kathy. Right? So she's walking in and said, you know, what a great thing that Antonio is singing here in high school. And what did you say?
I have to keep him here.
Yeah, right?
I have to keep him coming back.
Right? And yeah. You love the fact that he's singing here, right?
Love it, yes.
Right? And so for all the moms and dads and grandparents, just what a great blessing to have all of our kids working, you know, Travis and Michelle and Helen, among others, are working very hard just to continue to grow our music ministry. Antonio, we want to keep you here forever, right? Right? And what a great blessing. And what a great thing for us to come together this evening as we start the Advent season. So, you know, I think in a wonderful way, tonight is all about setting the tone. So if you think about all the things that are going on, right, you know, there's a thousand voices out there. But by the fact that we are choosing to come together this evening, hopefully tonight sets the tone, if you will, for the next 3.5 weeks as we get ready for Christmas. And you're going to hear me say this relentlessly, right? And that's why there's literally a big sign on the corner. Jesus is? He is the reason, right? And especially more than ever, what is the gift that everybody needs? Jesus. We don't need more coats or games or toys or TVs. What do we need most? Jesus. Now, the coats, the toys, all those are not wrong or bad. But what do we need most? Jesus. So tonight, as you go through this time and as you listen to beautiful music and wonderful voices, really you just use it as a moment again to set the tone for the days and the weeks ahead. He is the centering point. He is the foundation. He is the reason. He is the perfect peace that we need in our hearts, that we need in our homes, and God knows that we need in our community and in our world, right? So let's, tonight as we gather together, so blessed to be together, so blessed to be part of a large and active community. This is one of wonderful many music things that are coming up. We have Rhett Walker coming, that's contemporary Christian. We have Steve Angrisano and Sarah Hart on the 15th. You know their music. We have the Singing Angels on the 16th. Why is music so important? It's the same reason that we're so blessed to have Travis and Michelle and all the people working in our music ministry, because music planted deep in our hearts, it sticks with us. And it literally sets the tone. So take a couple deep breaths. Let's place ourselves before the Lord, and let's really open wide our ears and our heart so that the tone, the message, the songs of Advent, the songs of Christmas can be with us. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you.
light a candle, keep it burning. Shine a path to peace returning. Light a candle, warm and caring for the fearful and despairing. Light a candle, so revealing, ardent prayers for hope and healing.
You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. This is the verdict. Light has come into the world, but people love darkness instead of light because their deeds were evil. Everyone who does evil hates the light and will not come into the light for fear that their deeds will be exposed. But whoever lives by the truth comes into the light so that it may be seen plainly in what they have done and have been doing in the sight of God. When Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. The word of the Lord. Thank you. This is how the birth of Jesus the Messiah came about. Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save the people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," which means God with us.
God, love divine, come into our lives. Make me to know your ways, O God. Teach me your path. Guide me. You are my Savior. To you, O God, I lift up my soul. Lift up my spirit to my Lord. To you, I lift up my soul. Good and upright, O gracious God, show me the way, guiding the humble to justice. To you, O God, I lift up my soul, lift up my spirit to my Lord. To you, I lift up my soul. Dead and kind is your ways, O God. Oh, reveal your covenant, know your friendship.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder, or as in the day of Midian's defeat. You have shattered the yoke that burdens them, the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor. Every warrior's boot used in battle and every garment rolled in blood will be destined for burning, will be fuel for the fire. For unto us a child is born, for unto us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonder Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing it and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. night the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, O hear the angel voices, O night divine, O night when Christ was born, O night.
A faith serenely beaming, with glowing hearts by his cradle we stand. So led by light of a star faintly gleaming, here came the wise men from Orient land.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to marry him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joys for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
Wednesday, know you, to love you, to choose you first. On Thursday and Friday and Saturday, to see you, behold you in worship singing.
Hallelujah, holy, holy, glory to the King of Kings.
Hallelujah, holy, holy, all honor and glory belong to you. Christ will sing in the morning. I love the King and he loves me. All that I'm compelled to bring is my everyday offering. Your mercy's new every morning. I come alive as you're calling. All that I'm compelled to bring is my everyday offering.
It's every day.
Paging Helen. Oh, she's right there.
That's not embarrassing.
We should not need music for this.
Thank you. Thank you.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. In Bethlehem in Israel, the blessed babe was born, and laid within a manger upon this blessed morn. And with his mother Mary did nothing take in scorn. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum.
Bum 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 to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum.
Hey!
Thank you so much for coming out this evening. And everyone wave to the people watching a live stream. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much to Father Bob and for his support, and Helen and Michelle and Denise and Mary Lou and Donna for the handbells. And it's just a big team effort. And there's just so much going on here that if I forgot anyone, I'm sorry, but it's in the program, so. for our final song, we're going to do a sing-along of the Advent theme song. So, if you would please, turn to number 58 in the Breaking Bread, Emmanuel. That's going to be our Advent theme song. We are also introducing the refrain, which we'll sing for Christmas in this mashup. So it's number 79. So you'll hear that refrain, Christ our light will come. And then for Christmas, we'll sing the original text, Christ our light has come. Okay, so while you're turning there, I'm going to try to convince you to sing out strongly. There are many studies that have shown that singing improves health. Yep. It lowers stress, boosts immunity and lung function, enhances memory, improves mental health, and helps you cope with physical and emotional pain. In addition to creating feelings of well-being, singing can help you have greater relaxation responses, improved breathing, a healthier heart and immune system, and better posture. If you want to learn more, just Google singing health benefits and you'll see lots of results, including one from healthline.com. So, I encourage you to sing. You don't have to have a great voice, and come sing in the choir too, because that'd be awesome. Okay, so I invite you to sing out strongly, and thank you for Jacob for doing sound too. He's back there doing sound. All right, great. So this, you can be leaders when we come to Mass. You can sing this out for everyone so that they can really, really learn it. By the way, there's this intro that is new that you're going to hear at the beginning, and it's going to be each week during Mass. It's not in your Breaking Bread because Steve Angrisano and I wrote it just for this parish. So it's an intro that's going to be different each week, but it's a very simple phrase you just repeat after the cantor, and then each one gets a little bit louder, and then we get into Emmanuel. So she'll bring you in, just repeat after the cantor.
Our hope is drawing near.
Thank you so much, everyone. God bless you during this Advent. And thank you so much also to Mike for picking the readings and reading tonight. It's made a special evening. Thank you, everyone. God bless you.